start with this fuel tank, and then we'll put the fuel there inside the tank. We've got a fuel filter here and a pipe coming off the fuel filter, which attaches to a carburetor, and the carburetor attaches to the engine. I've made the carburetor slightly bigger than it should be for this size of engine, so I can show what's going on inside the carburetor. Okay, so this is the pulse line, and its job is to make a connection for flow from the crankcase here all the way up through this tube to the top of the carburetor there. And this area of the carburetor is known as the fuel pump area. There's a little chamber in here, as we can see there, and we'll see in a moment that this area is designed to be occupied alternately between a positive pushing pressure and a negative vacuum pressure. And this little structure shown in green here is the fuel pump diaphragm, and this is responsible for pumping all the fuel around the carburetor. And it's this diaphragm that responds to the pressures up above there in the chamber in order to work as a pump. And it's important to mention at this point that the upper chamber here, which is for the air pressure, is separated from the lower chamber here, which is for fuel. And the diaphragm in the centre there, which separates the two, is both fluid tight and airtight. So in a nutshell, the pulse line is a pipe that allows constant flow connection from the crankcase to the carburetor. So that's what it is, and now let's take a look how it works. Okay, so now we'll start the engine, and as the crankshaft turns and the piston lowers, it creates a pressure in the crankcase beneath it. That pressure pushes the reed valve onto its seat and also pushes some pressure through the pulse line here to the carburetor. And that pressure forced out of the pulse line pushes down on this flexible part of the fuel pump diaphragm, forcing this down. When this is down, there's a valve over this side which closes, and then there's a valve over this side which opens, and we'll see this a little clearer when we've got fuel in a moment. And so the piston continues to lower, keeping those pressures in the crankcase. And now as the piston rises, let's have a look what's going on now. Well, because the piston's now rising, it's creating a vacuum behind it, pulling up. And because there's a vacuum under the piston again, that's felt through the pulse line and sucks that fuel pump diaphragm back up. And as it did so, it created a vacuum of its own and drew fuel out of the fuel tank, down through the fuel pipes, into the carburetor, through this one-way valve, and then ended up underneath it. And the next time this diaphragm lowers, the fuel will be pushed this way. And we'll see that a little clearer in a moment. And as the piston continues to rise, it keeps bringing in the air and fuel underneath it. And then we get to top dead centre, and then the piston starts to lower and compress all that air and fuel beneath it. And the pressure is doing its usual of lowering the diaphragm and closing the reed valve. And that lowering of the diaphragm forces the fuel that was underneath it through this one-way valve and ensures plenty of fuel down here in the metering area, ready for the engine to use on its next cycle. We can see there that each time the diaphragm rises, it creates a vacuum and draws in fuel as a result of that vacuum underneath it. And so as the fuel's drawn in then down the fuel pipe, it opens this valve here because this valve opens downwards. So it nicely lifts that valve off its seat, and all of that fuel drawn in then just sits underneath that diaphragm. And when the direction of pressure from the pulse line pushes in on top of the diaphragm as a result of the piston lowering, then it pushes down on the diaphragm, and that of course forces down on that fuel. So that creates a pressure in the fuel, and the fuel tries to go this way, but because the downward flap was there, it's actually pushed the flap back up onto its seat, so the fuel can't go any further that way. So it goes this way. And when it does so, it opens this valve flap up off its seat because this valve flap opens upwards. And so it flows past and continues down the carburetor here, past the needle valve and into the metering area, where it's available for the jet to use inside the inlet of the carburetor for the engine. And so when the pressure above the diaphragm changes then, so when the pulse line creates a vacuum there because of the piston raising, creating a vacuum through there and drawing that diaphragm upwards, the process then repeats itself, and then so on and so on. Any loss of pumping efficiency of this pump, then we're not going to get the fuel down into the metering area available for the main jet for the engine. So the pulse line turns energy from the engine into working energy for the fuel pump to pump that fuel around the carburetor.